Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. In this video, we'll be discussing how to prepare curved molar root canal using a combination of balanced force technique and rotary files. So let's go ahead and watch. We are going to use 8 and 10 number K files, nickel titanium hand files 15 to 40 number and pro taper gold rotary files. This is extracted maxillary molar. The palatal root has a double curvature. This is a point of first curvature and this is second curvature. Now I'll be demonstrating how to prepare this curved root canal. The access cavity of the tooth is already made. Now the first step here is to estimate the working length from the preoperative X-ray. The estimated working length is marked on the file and it is inserted in the canal to the point of deepest penetration. Now here we see that this is short of the working length, indicating that it is a narrow calcified canal. We are going to do apical preparation with balanced force technique. For this, I have marked a point on the file like this. Using this technique, the file is rotated in right and left direction in different arcs. Now as the instrument is inserted, it is rotated in clockwise direction to 90 to maximum 180 degree like this. Now this movement positions the cutting edges equally in the surrounding walls. In the next action, we move the file in anti-clockwise direction from 120 degree to a maximum of 270 degree like this. And we use inward pressure while we are moving in this direction. Now with gentle oscillations in right and left direction and light inward pressure, the instrument is carried gradually to the working length. I have explained this technique in great detail in my previous video. You can watch it in case you have any doubt. Now we have reached the working length. Now at this point we will perform third type of movement. That is, the instrument will be rotated to one full turn in a clockwise direction and it will be pulled out. Now this motion loads the debris on the flutes of the file and it removes them. The 5 number file is inserted in the coronal portion and circumferential filing is done, in which the file is moved all along the walls of the canal in up and down motion. This is done to enlarge the coronal 1/3 of the canal. This step is done because the canal is narrow and partially calcified. So before we use any rotary instrument, it is very important that a proper canal space has been created. It is very important to always keep in mind that the rotary files can be used only after there is a confirmed reproducible glide path. I've discussed in detail how to use these files in the above mentioned video. Do check it out. I'm starting the preparation with SX or Shaper X file. Now this file is shorter than other Pro Taper Gold files. In the first step, we coat it with a lubricant and then we insert it in the canal. It is used in a brushing motion in which we intentionally brush to the outer wall, that means cut the outer wall. This moves the canal slightly away from the focation and gives a better coronal shape to the canal. On irrigation, you can see how much debris has come out. This shows that active cutting has taken place. After that, we recapitulate the canal with 20 number file. Working length is marked on the S1 file and it is coated with a lubricant and then placed in the canal. Now this file is allowed to passively float in the canal and follow the glide path. Now these shaping files, they are used like a brush. That means they cut in the outstroke and they cut laterally when they are being pulled out. Just like this, you can see. From the irrigation, you can see the amount of debris that has come out. That means active cutting took place. And then recapitulation is done with 20 number file. S2 file is used in a manner similar to S1 file. It actively cuts the middle one-third of the canal. And together S1 and S2, they cut and prepare the coronal two-thirds of the root canal. After using the shaping files, we come to the finishing files or the F files. Now these files, they have been specifically designed to shape the apical one-third of the root canal. But also they progressively enlarge and shape the middle one-third of the canal. Now these files, they are allowed to passively float into the canal till they reach the working length and then they are pulled out. After which, irrigation is done, which is followed by recapitulation. Generally, only one finishing instrument is required to prepare the apical one-third of the canal. I take a gutta percha cone matching with the finishing instrument that I used, which was F1, and place it in the canal. I observe that there is a snug fit in the apical area. To check that, I take a radiograph. Here I can see that the proper apical seal has been achieved. We can proceed to the next step, which is obturation of the root canal. Now this was a very effective method of managing curved root canals without transporting the canals and preparing them evenly and smoothly. I hope you enjoyed your lecture. Do like it, share it with your friends and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.